After power outages left thousands in the dark earlier this week, some are taking a closer look at the state's grid reliability.
Leading Local Tonight reporter Maddie Beertemple has more on a bill in the legislature that outlines what energy sources the state's electricity could come from. Maddie?
Hi, Nicholas and Lauren. Intermittent sources like wind and solar don't provide enough energy to keep a state's lights on when the main power sources, coal and natural gas plants, have to shut down to protect equipment because of severe weather. That's just one part of the reason that Texas and parts of our state experienced rolling blackouts earlier this week. To prevent it from happening again, lawmakers want to bolster the state's support of coal, natural gas, and other sources available on demand to prevent too much reliance on renewable energy that they say alone won't keep a state running.
We're looking for reliability. We're looking for resilience in our electric grid.
In short, Senate Bill 2313 says electricity generated in North Dakota must come from energy ready on demand, like coal or natural gas. The bill is a boon to coal backers like Anna Novak, whose husband works at a mine north of Beulah.
So to say that coal is the lifeblood of our communities, it's almost minimizing how important it is to all of us back home.
But others say relying on coal and natural gas instead of a diversity of sources wouldn't prevent blackouts like Texas experienced.
That grid would have still failed because the supposedly dispatchable energy of natural gas and coal was unable to dispatch during that extreme weather event.
The bill doesn't rule out other energy sources entirely, but it does set rules on sources that aren't dispatchable or readily available for use.
Non-dispatchable sources can adversely affect a power grid because of their intermittence. Solar energy, for example, could be impacted by a cloudy day, and wind energy by a lack of wind.
According to the bill, those non-dispatchable sources, wind and solar, could still be used to generate electricity if they have backup capacity, meaning they make up for their lessened reliability by paying for some of the dispatchable energy.
And the main theme of the bill to begin with was firming up. It was meaning that you had to have backup for your renewable energy. And so that if you have wind or solar, you got to have natural gas or coal backing it up.
That firming requirement is something the co-owner of a solar company disagrees with.
All the firming requirement does is require the renewable energy subsidize the uneconomic operation of coal-fired power plants.
Senator Rich Wardner sponsored the bill and says it's not just about coal.
A lot of people think, you know, that this is a contest between fossil fuels and renewable fuels. I don't want it to be that. I want it to be where we work together and realizing that we have to have both.
The bill also repeals the state's adoption of the 25 by 25 initiative, which aims to have the U.S. producing 25% renewable energy by 2025.
The bill received an amendment submitted by Senator Wardner, which the Senate Energy and Natural Resources Committee passed. It would require the state to create yearly reports about the power grid. And Nicholas, Lauren, all laws will have to be reported out of committee by next Tuesday ahead of the crossover date when both houses swap legislation for further consideration.
Maddie Beertemple, thanks for breaking it down for us.
In our North Dakota.